dogs, yeah, have it falling off, yeah. Come with a classic, they come around, you say this, say it's a sleeper.
Oh my god.
We back at it. The video's about music that have nothing to do with the music itself. Quadrilogy. At this point, call me Ludwig van Zethoven. Call me Nay-Z. I love the marketing for albums. The album rollout. From the moment a new album is teased to the moment that it's released, the most creative artists are able to immerse us in the world of the album before we even listen to it. By the time we actually get the music, it feels like entering the gates to a place that we've only been able to catch a glimpse of, you know what I'm saying? Catch a little peek, jumping over the gates of a little. But how does an artist stand out in a sea of a kajillion other artists? There's a million things going on online. Everything is being marketed to us at once. There's movies, TV shows. There's an advertisement every 2 seconds. Just kidding. Not to mention there's a news story every day about something ridiculous. So how do you stand out? The perfect album rollout. Because of streaming, the album rollout has shortened considerably, which is a good thing to get the music sooner. But there's less time to build up memorable experiences around the music. Like with The Life of Pablo, I don't just remember listening to the songs. I remember the tracklist notepad with signatures from other artists being added to it, the changing album titles, the Madison Square Garden show, seeing the album cover for the first time and being like, what is this? Especially these days, most rollouts consist of just teasing your fans with snippets you hope will go viral on TikTok and hyping for years with no real date in sight. Drip feeding us. We're starving. So many albums and careers have been forgotten just because of bad marketing and a bad album rollout. I love how something as simple as an artist changing their look is seen as the start of a whole new era. Like when Kendrick goes from Cornrow Kenny to Kung Fu Kenny, we're like, oh my, something's happening, man. Something's happening. Which is why it blows me that Chance the Rapper is still wearing the three hats from 2016 for promoting his third album. Now we're on the fifth. You absolute buffoon. Bro, please. I want to feel like it's a new era. I want to feel like we're moving on to a new thing. At this point, I wouldn't be mad if he took off the three hat and put on a four hat. Only a few artists have really given us a rollout that feels like an event. But when they do, it's something really special.
No, you got to build a bigger world. I'm not going to make an album. I'm going to make like an album. I'm going to make the rollout dope. I'm going to make the movie with it dope. I'm going to make everything dope. I'm going to make a world.
There's a couple of different ways to do an album rollout. There's the traditional way, drop some singles, maybe a video, do the radio talks, podcasts, interviews, blah, blah, blah. That's a tried and true way that has worked for literally decades. And some people still manage to mess that up. But one of my favorites is low-key creating an alternate universe. Donald Glover's rollout for Because of the Internet is one of my favorite rollouts ever. All of a sudden, he started wearing this exact same outfit everywhere to every interview. In these interviews, he was kind of different from his usual, more comedic self.
Like, the idea is like, if I want to kill myself, I will. It's not hard to die. I could do it, like, right now. But, like, number two...
Jesus. Over time, people realized this is a character that he called The Boy. When the album dropped, he also dropped a screenplay that goes with the music about this same character, The Boy. And then the music videos that were dropped after were interconnected and having, like, an overarching story about an alien invasion or something. What's going on? Bro, this man is literally creating a universe here. This is so much more than he had to do. And I appreciate that. The Weeknd did the same kind of thing for last year's After Hours and had one of the best album rollouts in recent memory. This man created a character, dressed up as him for the entire year, and his music videos and live performances were like telling the same story. He'll have a live performance where he has bandages all over his face, and then the next video will be like plastic surgery after that, all culminating in the Super Bowl performance where he had like 100 different people playing the same character. This rollout literally felt like a movie. Just the entire dark, eerie, horror, Cut Gems vibe that he created was perfect. I love seeing things like this, like Tyler, the Creator, transforming into the character of Igor for his album.
Yes.
Janelle Monáe with her emotion picture visual album. An amazing pun. Which is why it was disappointing to me when Childish Gambino on the new album did like an anti-rollout. Let me set the stage for you real quick, okay? Let me just tell you how beautifully this man had set himself up for an incredible rollout. This man had a number one single, okay, with This Is America. He was on SNL as the host and the musical guest. Two Grammy wins. A movie on Amazon, a summer pack with two songs, a Lion King movie, all these things that seemed like it was perfect to gear up for an amazing drop, and then nothing. For a year, there was nothing. And then randomly dropped on the radio with no title, no freaking cover, no song titles. I brought this up a lot because it still confuses me to this day. He even put it on his website, and then it wasn't available on streaming until a week later, so it lost the whole, like, surprise drop aspect. The only thing that could have made this rollout worse is if it was at the very start of a pandemic. Oh, wait, it was. To this day, it bothers me but it also fascinates me.
We're heavily invested in your situation.
It's not easy to do a surprise release. Only a couple of artists can really pull that off perfectly in what I like to call the gotcha. It's not easy to do the gotcha. It's been done in the past by Prince and Radiohead, but the modern surprise drop was basically originated by Beyoncé self-titled in 2014.
I see music is more than just what I hear.
Just the fact that we didn't hear or know about any of this stuff in a time where it's basically impossible to not know everything before it happens. Everything is leaked. I try to watch anything, I go on Twitter, and there's already spoilers about it before it even comes out. Y'all were trying to guess the ending of WandaVision halfway into the first episode of WandaVision. But for this album, we didn't hear anything about it until it happened. And she had a video for freaking every song. How is that even possible? Everything changed with the Beyoncé joint. The Gotcha drop showed that in the internet age, there's still room for creativity and surprise. This led to Drake doing the same thing with If You're Reading This Is Too Late, Frank Ocean doing the same thing with Blonde. I'm telling you right now, there's nothing like waking up and seeing an entire album is already out. Usually we go through months of buildup and singles and speculation. She said, we're not doing none of that.
I miss that immersive experience. Now people only listen to a few seconds of a song. They don't really invest in a whole album.
U2 kind of had a surprise drop, but they low-key did it in the worst way of all time. It was announced at an Apple event and released on iTunes the same day at no cost. But the problem was it appeared in everybody's phone and you couldn't delete it even if you wanted to. For 3 years, there was just this picture of this man hugging his son's stomach in my library. I was like, get this out of here. Most people literally can't tell you anything about this album besides the backlash. I've never seen so many people so mad at getting something for free. On the other hand of the Gotcha drop, there's what I refer to as the endless hype rollout. We knew about this album 2 years before it released. Travis Scott announced this album, his third album, before the second album was even released. He was hyping this thing like it was the Bible 2. It took on like a mythological feeling. The Legend of Astroworld. I remember thinking I was gonna be 80 years old, like,
some say Astroworld is still going to release.
But no, it actually came out. Travis was able to combine the endless hype with creating a world too. Astroworld has the imagery of space, theme parks. When you were going to a Travis concert in 2018, you weren't like, oh, I'm gonna go see Travis live. It was like, no, I'm going to Astroworld. It was either you're going to Astroworld or you're getting left behind. And that helped with the lore of this album and the hype, and it was massive. Of course, the music had to be good, but if it wasn't for this rollout, I honestly don't think we would see Travis working with freaking McDonald's, PS5, Fortnite, the Super Bowl, Tenet soundtrack, Reese's Puffs. This man is gonna run out of brands to work with. It actually says he's doing a sponsor for Arby's Meat Mountain. Not only that, but the features were hidden, which encouraged you to listen to the whole album and get surprised every time somebody shows up.
Sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know.
This created its own hype and its own experience outside of just listening to the music. This man had Drake, The Weeknd, Tame Impala, Frank Ocean, Stevie Wonder, and he didn't put their names in it. That's a freaking flex, man. That's like if Drake was in this video and I didn't put it in the title or thumbnail. Speaking of Frank Ocean, he combined the endless hype with the surprise drop. He had the endless hype and he literally released a project called Endless.
Coincidence?
Lil Uzi did the same thing with Eternal A Take. Cardi did it with Whole Lotta Red. Give the people a name to latch onto and then tease it for years, just allowing the mythology to build and grow. Beethoven had a crazy rollout. Y'all don't remember the hype before Fur Elise dropped? Everybody was like, nah, he's falling off. He hasn't dropped a hit since Symphony Number 9. One thing about the endless hype rollout is that it has to live up to expectations, which isn't easy. That's why I like the Gotcha. You don't have to spend months building hype and dropping singles. It avoids one of the things I hate the most about the album rollout, when artists drop 60% of the album as singles already. Dropping all the best songs on the album before it even comes out. It's like putting all the best scenes of your movie in the trailer. By the time you watch the movie, you've already experienced all the best parts. It's just like, the first song that's released should set the tone for what people expect, but you gotta pick a good first single. Yummy single-handedly ruined that last Justin Bieber album rollout. And that album actually has some bangers. And y'all are sleeping on that album because of Yummy.
Yeah, that's what love is. That's what you love is.
Oh my god, come on, man. That's bad. Get out of here. But making Yummy the big lead single and then doubling down on it and trying to get everybody make it number one, it made everybody write off the entire album. Now, on the other hand, if you have an amazing first single like
No One Meant to Have All That Power,
the My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy rollout is bringing stuff of legends, dude. Literally, it's like a Greek story. There was the incident with Taylor Swift, led to Kanye's exile. He disappeared in Hawaii, creating music with some of the best artists. Everybody had to wear suits in the studio. And then coming back to the VMAs with this performance of Runaway. And then the rollout of the actual album was Good Fridays, dropping a new free track every week leading up to the actual release of the album. This was Kanye using the internet at its best when Twitter and everything was just starting out. This man is good at the rollout, which I like to refer to as the absolutely bonkers rollout. For Yeezus, this man unveiled the first single by projecting his face on buildings in 60 different locations. They showed the album artwork and it was just a clear case, CD, and red tape like you're getting a bootleg. It drew attention to it. It was absolutely bonkers. He also had one of the only good drama beef rollouts with 50 Cent, where they had a friendly competition, kind of, to see who would sell the most albums first week. Beef is the worst way to do an album rollout, man. Some artists, the only way they know how to have any attention on their own music is being super confrontational with another artist. They'll say something wild and be like, "By the way, my album is dropping soon." No, do your own thing. I cannot stand this method, bro. Nobody's caring about you or the music. They're only there for the drama. Having said that, Mr. Beast, I disliked your last video. That's right, I said it. It just wasn't my cup of tea. By the way, guys, I got a new single coming out this Friday featuring Mr. Beast. The most underrated rollout is when artists are of the people, when they actually build relationships with their fans. Daft Punk launched their Random Access Memories album in the random town of Weewa, Australia.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
J. Cole was literally just pulling up to people's houses. This man did a house tour. Imagine you wake up and J. Cole is just looking over you, just in your house. Yeah. 2 Chainz built the pink trap house that was on his album cover, where they had community events and parties, and now it's an Atlanta landmark. These blur the line between celebrity and regular person and builds better connection with the fans and makes them want to listen to the music. The modern way to market music can be basically defined in one word: snippets. Lil Nas X using memes for Old Town Road, super internet savvy. He's been hyping up this one song since like last July. It was even in a Super Bowl commercial before he released it. Playboi Carti is like a human song snippets. This seems like the future of this super fast-paced ADHD music consuming world we're in right now. But I appreciate the world building that some artists are able to do. A messy rollout doesn't necessarily mean a bad album either. Anti had a notoriously messy rollout, and that album, it's still a classic. The music lasts longer than the rollout. The music is what's really going to be remembered. But the rollout is an opportunity to create a moment. I don't even know how many people actually think about this. It's just something I love. I even made my own album rollout in 2017, even though I don't make music. I created a soundtrack story through playlists as a rollout for my merch, with a character and album covers and a track list. I worked with HK from Brockhampton to create all the visuals. It's low-key one of the best things I've ever done. I cannot lie. What's your favorite album rollout or way that an album was marketed? Do you prefer the huge buildup, or do you want it just dropped in your lap randomly? Let me know in the comments down below. I think there should be rollouts for everything. Actually, this entire video has been a rollout for my child. That's right, guys, I got a baby on the way. Here's a sneak peek. Here's the tease for the name. Let me know what you guys think it is. He's dropping at midnight tonight. So, gotcha.